Praise the Lord, everybody. This is Pastor Walter Tucker III, and I am glad to be with you one more time for my weekly program, Revelation to You, in which I share spiritual concepts, knowledge, wisdom, and understanding so that we can walk in the victory that God has purposed for us to walk in. So, this week, I want to share with you a very familiar verse of Scripture, Romans chapter 10 and verse 17, which reads, "So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God." As I said, if you've been in the faith, word of faith teaching for any amount of time, you've heard the scripture. Let's talk about what it means. It means that your faith grows and is built up as you continue to hear the word of God. In other words, your faith is like a seed, and it has to be watered. And the more you water it, the more it grows. So God has given to every man, to all of us, the measure of faith. But that faith has to be watered. And it's watered by continuing to hear the word over and over and over again. You have to hear it taught to you through pastors like myself. You have to hear it in your ears through your own mouth. And you have to hear it in your ears and your heart through meditation, which is silent hearing. So it's very important, because teaching is repetition until learning takes place. Studies have shown that we actually only retain 10% of what we hear. So on that Sunday morning, in the Sunday morning worship service, when you're hearing the message and you're shouting and you're praising, saying amen, that's good. You got some things, but the truth of the matter is you left more on the table than you took home. So it's important to continue to hear, whether you get the CD, whether you go online, listen by Facebook or YouTube, that's the way to do it. You want to continue to hear the message. You want to continue to hear the word so it gets down in your spirit. You know, there are so many things that work against and fight against the word of God. What you used to think, what people are saying even in the world today, all of these things are constantly working against the word of God in your mind. You know, the scripture says in 2 Corinthians 10, it says that we should cast down imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Anything that is contrary to what God said, you got to fight against it. You have to overcome it with the truth. So what am I really saying to you? I'm saying that the word works, but you got to work the word. I'm saying to you that the word will increase your faith. It will cause you to grow and be a mighty man and a mighty woman of God. But you got to put your work in. You have to realize that the more you hear it, the more will get into your spirit. And when it gets into your spirit, what's going to happen is your spirit will be strong. And instead of reacting to the facts of life, you'll respond by the word of God. You'll respond to God. Don't react to the facts. Respond by the word to God. So take that with you. Keep on listening. Don't give up. Don't think, wow, it's taking all this. Yeah, it's taking that, but it's going to bear the great fruit of righteousness. God bless you, and I'll see you next week on Revelation to You.